my very first time.
Yeah. Happy, happy. Love you, Hope and Streets.
I have this thing at Halloween, I'm wearing infrastructure costumes on my head, so it made sense.
You gotta give more space, baby. You gotta make it do it, baby.
This is a bridge that has 10 total lanes, and only one of them is meant for people who are walking, biking, running, scooters, strollers, wheelchairs. Why do we have one lane for all those forms of mobility?
And eventually they got down to, oh, we can't do this because of money. And so, listen, council members have discretionary funds. And Jimmy and I both actually let you choose how to spend some of our discretionary funds. And so the fact that we should have to pay for it doesn't quite make sense, but it doesn't matter because we will.
No more excuses. We can do this now. Absolutely. We have the resources. We just need the political will from the side of the mayor's office.
For my birthday in June, because I finally felt like I could try riding a bicycle for the first time on 34th Avenue in Jackson Heights. I cannot tell you how many neighbors have told me that they've had the same experience. Yeah. And that means that our streets and our bridges need to keep up to date with the infrastructure that is necessary to keep us safe.
I think it's been a really long slog. Let's get to the finish line and get this thing open.
Look, we still have to come out on the streets to get things done under the de Blasio administration. On one hand, it's exhilarating that people turn out and we fight and we win. On the other hand, it's depressing that we don't have city leadership that's just doing this.
The pandemic has been awful in so many ways, but it has allowed us to start reimagining parts of this city. The open streets program has been great. The outdoor dining that's now going to be permanent has been great. This should become a part of that same philosophy.
What do we want? More space. When do we want it? Now. What do we want? More space. When do we want it? Now.
We're here to ask for the dignity to be able to walk and bike. For the equity, because we know that commuting time is one of the biggest single indicators of moving people out of generational poverty.
This is such a simple, easy, ridiculous issue that should be fixed right now.
Should be forever and ever. We need it.
I love the walk. It's beautiful.
There was just so much space. It's just better for everyone.
You know, I'm just glad so many people are here and we're gonna win this thing.
This is a movement, and I want to thank all of you for being the heart and soul of a movement to change car culture and car culture in the city of New York. That's what we're here to do.